problem that they got. Amir Ali Khan, the Global Peace Foundation. CM Maximilu Mudiraj Garu, Dr. M. Ramnarayan Mudiraj, distinguished invitees, our chief guest, Thomas Siraduddin Garu, and guests of honor, we have Prof. D. Bhagyanarayan Garu, our special, very, very special guest, Justice Vaman Rao Deshpande Garu, Janab Nazirudin Ahmed Garu, other distinguished invitees, and dear students. Today is a very special day because I request all the youngsters here to recall under what conditions the United Nations Organization came into being. Friends, 20th century witnessed two world wars. The First World War from 1914 to 18 and the Second World War from 1939 to 45. After the First World War, an attempt was made to create and establish a global body, and that is how the League of Nations came into being. But then, you know, that was just a starting point. It was something like a first initiative. There was a lot of defects in it. It could not function properly and finally it collapsed. After the Second World War, the leaders of the global community, they all decided enough is enough, because I just saw a beautiful recall towards the end of the Second World War. The world witnessed two major bombings. Two atom bombs were dropped on August 6th and the second one on August 9th on Hiroshima and Nagasaki in Japan. And what were the big crimes the Japanese have committed? Okay, it's during the wartime. About 3,000 Navy men, American Navy Marines were killed in Pearl Harbor. But that was war. The killing was on both sides. But dropping a nuclear bomb on civilian population where lakhs and lakhs of people were crippled and destroyed, nations came into being and they have been working marvelously. Every day, you know, all of us who are living right now on this planet Earth, we should be grateful to the United Nations for the wonderful work it has been doing so far. Recently, right from 1972, when they organized the first conference on human environment in Stockholm, since the year 1992, at Rio de Janeiro, that is popularly described as the Earth Summit. That is, all the nations of the world gathered at a single place and they discussed the common problems faced by humanity and life on this planet Earth. Youngsters, I am appealing to all of you that you can bring peace only through unity. And unity you can bring, you can create unity by foundation for a healthy speech. My humble submission is that this year, the theme, United Nations has given a theme. The theme for today is that the world shall come together, and the theme is the Sustainable Development Goals. Building blocks of peace, Sustainable Development Goals. For all the youngsters here, I know you are in the first year, second year, third year of graduation. Appreciating the good work being done by the United Nations, trying to sort out global issues, trying to weld the people as one global citizenship. I need to appreciate my good friend, Mr. Farooq Ali Khan. Basically, he's the son of Amir Ali Khan, you know, who has been a gold medalist and a topper in the Hyderabad Civil Service. He worked as not only as collector but subedar and finally almost like the chief secretary of the then Hyderabad State. And basically he was a statesman. He was associated my friend Ramnarayan and Dr. Ramnarayan Mudiraj. You know, I think I always say he's one of the very few persons of Hyderabad who is always ready to respond to a major issue, whether it is ozone protection day or peace or anything, you know, you will always find Dr. Gandhar and Mukhirajs always in the front trying to do something. This is what is more important, friends.
Thank you very much, sir.
This Subedar Amir Ali Khan Global Peace Foundation, we are organizing the so many programs like this, and I welcome all of you to this Global Peace Foundation. Now I request all of you, Yuri Africa, I request to stand up for 2 minutes. Thank you very much. Oh, Alex.
Good morning. Good morning. Greetings to all of you on the mission of the International Peace Day. President of today's function, General Farooq Ali Khan, sir. Secretary, Chief Guest of this morning's function, Janab Mohammad Siraj Ali Sir, Guest of Honor and a noted historian, Janab Nasiruddin Ahmed Sir, Special Guest, Honorable Justice Mohammad Rao Deshpande Sir, distinguished Lord Speaker and student class. At the outset, I congratulate and compliment the Farooq Ali Khan Sahab and his team for organizing this International Peace Day under the auspices of the Sardar Amir Ali Khan Global Peace Foundation. I also thank them profusely for inviting me to this present function. Friends, all the religions will lead to God. God is one. Power. God has no religion. You think the evolution of the religion for Buddhism 3000 years old. Beyond that, when was man admitted onto this planet Earth? Thousands of years old. What this civilization, where wasn't there any God? Does that God has any religion? No. When such is the case, why we should fight in the name of the religion, in the name of the language, in the name of the state, in the name of the country? So my dear friends, you can achieve peace by loving yourself, by respecting yourself, by respecting your family members, your elders, your parents, your teachers, your fellow human beings. When you start respecting them, when you start respecting their religion, when you start respecting their ways and means of living, naturally you will be spontaneously spreading the love and well-being among the human beings. If you want to end the world, instead of sending the guns, send the pens. If you want to end the war, instead of sending tanks, send the books. If you want to end the war, instead of sending the soldiers who sent the teachers. This is the petition from Malala Yousafzai. To get a pledge that we will try to bring the peace, try to bring the harmony, try to bring happiness among ourselves, so that we will be a better world to our future generations. So once again, thank Sardar Amir Ali Khan on the Peace Foundation. Now, we may not be knowing about Sardar Amir Ali Khan, sir. He was a subedar in the erstwhile state of Hyderabad. He was a noble person who has helped thousands of people, thousands of downtrodden people. He has established several schools to educate the children. He was a very good administrator, lofty ideas, and he was a secular minded person. Now, on his name is Subedar Amir Ali Khan Global Peace Foundation. Was established, and it is being held by none other than General Farooq Ali Khan, sir, his worthy son. I hope and wish that this foundation will strive more to establish peace, happiness, and well-being and brotherhood among all of this state, this country. Thank you.